Good morning, everyone. To those of you who are here at St. Michael's and All Angels, Bassett Avenue, and to those of you as well who are joining us online. Today we're keeping our patronal festival, the Feast of St. Michael and All Angels. The order of service has been given out in church and is available to download from the parish website. We begin our service today with hymn number 223, In Church, we will omit verses 2 and 5. The verses online have those omissions already.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We have come to Holy Zion, the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, to myriads of angels, to God, the judge of all, and to Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Woe is me, for I am lost. I am a person of unclean lips. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Our guilt is taken away. Our sin is forgiven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May God, who loved the world so much that he sent his Son to be our Saviour, forgive you your sins and make you holy to serve him in the world through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Everlasting God, you have ordained and constituted the ministries of angels and mortals in a wonderful order. Grant that as your holy angels always serve you in heaven, so at your command they may help and defend us on earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The Old Testament reading is taken from Genesis chapter 28, reading verses 10 to 17. Jacob left Beersheba and went towards Haran. He came to a certain place and stayed there for the night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones of the place, he put it under his head and lay down in that place. And he dreamed that there was a ladder set up on the earth, the top of it reaching to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And the Lord stood beside him and said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham your father, and the God of Isaac. The land on which you lie I will give to you and to your offspring. And your offspring shall be like the dust of the earth, and you shall spread abroad to the west and to the east and to the north and to the south. And all the families of the earth shall be blessed in you and in your offspring. Know that I am with you and will keep you wherever you go, and I will bring you back to this land. For I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. Then Jacob woke from his sleep and said, Surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. And he was afraid and said, How awesome is this place! This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand if you're so able for this psalm.
The second reading is taken from the book of Revelation, chapter 12, beginning at verse 7. And war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon. The dragon and his angels fought back, but they were defeated, and there was no longer any place for them in heaven. The great dragon was thrown down, that ancient serpent, who is called the devil and Satan, the deceiver of the whole world. He was thrown down to the earth, and his angels were thrown down with him. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven proclaiming, "Now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Messiah, for the accuser of our comrades has been thrown down, who accuses them day and night before our God. But they have conquered him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, for they did not cling to life even in the face of death. Rejoice then, you heavens, and those who dwell in them. But woe to the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down to you with great wrath, because he knows that his time is short." This is the word of the Lord.
The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. When Jesus saw Nathanael coming towards him, he said of him, "Here is an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you come to know me?" Jesus replied, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Heavenly Father, may these words that I speak reach the goal for which you have prepared them. Anything that is not of you, would you please take away, and only that which is of you remain. Being the parent of a 25 and 21-year-old is a real blessing at times. It does mean that we do get to see some silly films every now and again, and we continue to see silly films even though they are 25 and 21. Now, one such silly film that we never ever got to saw, for which I'm really, really grateful, but I have heard an incredible amount, is the Lego movie. Has anybody come across the Lego movie? No? Yes? Yeah. Yes. I have a hand. Yes? Yay! I mean, really, who even knew that you could make a movie out of Lego features? But apparently you can. And one of the big features of this film is to say that everyone is awesome if you're part of a team. Everything is awesome. And I could sing you the song, but I'm not going to, because I don't think you'd like it too much. So according to the Lego movie, everything is awesome. But is that really, really true? Awesome. What really is awesome? It's one of those words, isn't it, that kind of creeps into the language more and more. And actually, do we really know what it means? I guess you could become very hippie now and say, everything's awesome, man. But I'm not going to do that for you either, because, you know, Lego or hippie is not quite the thing, I don't think. It could mean impressive, or magnificent, or overwhelming, or stunning, or wonderful, majestic, wondrous. Our festival day today remembers St. Michael and all angels, all of them. Now, there aren't many references to them in the Bible. There's a few times in Luke, the birth narratives especially, and in our readings today. Our reading from Revelation shows Michael the archangel commanding the angel armies and defeating the fallen angel, the serpent. Now, that would be an awesome prospect, an awesome thing to see. Envisaging that. And actually, at the back of the church, we are always looking at, but you don't get to see in quite the same way, the magnificent window that we have here of the triumphant Michael, who has conquered the devil, the serpent. What a victory. How awesome. So this word is first found in the English language about the 16th century, apparently, to be filled with awe, rather than the more colloquial meanings that we have today. Not sure any of this really helps us, though, to get to grips with what the word awesome really means. And what's more, this sort of feeling upbeat word is found, perhaps surprisingly, in our Old Testament reading this morning. If you could have the reading in front of you and have a look at verse 17, which is right at the end of that reading, Jacob says, "How awesome is this place?" What's going on here with Jacob? Why is it so awesome? And why does Jesus, in our gospel reading today, reflect on this event, pointing to himself? Now, a little bit of background. This comes in Jacob's life when he's fleeing from Esau, his brother. Family feuds are nothing new, and the one that these two had was very complicated and quite bitter at times. Now, Jacob, with his mother's connivance, had stolen Esau's birthright to be their father Isaac's heir. And then, after being found out, he runs away because he realizes the enormity of what he's done and because Esau has sworn vengeance on him. The episode we have in our Genesis reading, he's forced to sleep outside, even having a stone as a pillow. And I guess it shows just how utterly tired he was that he could actually fall asleep on a stone pillow. And despite this, or maybe because of this, he has the most amazing dream. A dream in verse 12 of our reading of a ladder reaching from heaven to earth and with angels going up and down on it. Now, it doesn't say here who those angels are, but we know about Michael and Gabriel, so perhaps we can assume that they are part of that angelic band going up and down. They are the ones going from Jacob. The ladder stands upon him. God assures Jacob of his plans for him, plans about descendants being found all over the earth. And this will be possible because God's going to protect Jacob, being with him wherever, however, and whenever. Now, I don't know about you, but I think that's quite a promise. Quite a promise when you're fleeing for your life, wondering if you're going to survive the righteous wrath of your brother. Quite a promise, not just about survival, but also your future and future generations. truly amazing. How awesome is that? And that's what he says. This place, the place where he was so blessed by the presence of God, by the angels whose actions would bring about these promises, perhaps, this place, it's the gate of heaven, the gateway to heaven. And so he calls it the house of God. It's through this place, indeed, through his body, indeed, that all these things can take place. And so this is the background to our gospel reading, a truly awesome event and place and a life-changing for Jacob. Later on in his story, he wrestles with another angel, God himself, and he's allowed to win. And so has his name changed from Jacob, meaning the supplanter, the one who's taken his brother's place. It's changed to Israel, which means the one who fights with or the one who wrestles with God. And it's this name that we are far more familiar with, perhaps, the one after whom the country is named, and we still have it definitely today. And it's founded because he has so many sons who become the founding tribes of this new country. So things for you to remember. Jacob is the place where all this happens, through whom God has plans for a whole new people, where the house of God, Bethel, is set up. Jacob wrestles with God and has his name changed to Israel, the name given to this new people. And Jacob calls it awesome. Now let's look at our gospel reading, and hopefully you may see some very real similarities between the two passages about the angels ascending and descending to and from heaven. In the gospel account, however, the angels are ascending and descending not on Jacob, but Jesus himself, upon the Son of Man. Now, Nathanael is struck to the core, the truth of who Jesus is, because Jesus knew where he was previously to the encounter he has with Jesus. And because of this, Nathanael is struck, and he acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, the King of Israel, the one whom had been promised in the Old Testament, the Messiah. Nathanael has this realization and conversion, if you like, and steps out in faith, simply grounded on that one miracle. That one miracle that Jesus had supernatural knowledge about him. Now, Jesus doesn't belittle this step of faith, but he does say that there will be so much more, many, many more signs to show his identity. Indeed, in the next chapter, the first of the signs recorded by John happens. In John chapter 2, we have the miracle of the wedding at Cana, the water being turned into wine. There is so much more to see, so much more to know, to live, to follow in Jesus than simply saying who he is. And then, in verse 51, we come to the deliberate echo of Jacob and the ladder. But this time, it's not Jacob on whom the ladder is placed, but Jesus. With Jacob, he recognized that the place where this happened was very special, the house of God, where God was happy to be associated with. With Jesus, the angels are ascending and descending on him. Heaven is open above him, and the angels are heaven sent, all as confirmation that the one the disciples see as the Messiah is the one appointed by God. For Jacob, who became known as Israel, remember he was the father of the 12 tribes that become the country of Israel. But now, rather than Israel, we have God himself, Jesus, the Messiah. He is the new Israel, the new place, the new house of God. No longer in one physical place, because the house of God is a person, Jesus. All of Jesus' ministry is tied up with this title, Son of Man. From the heavens that opened at his baptism, the blessings poured out through him, through the signs he performs, the revelation of his word, the life that he lives, to what his death and resurrection will accomplish, until all is fulfilled when the Son of Man welcomes us all, redeemed by his actions, redeemed to himself, to the Father's house. It's this, at the last, for Nathanael and all his disciples, and indeed us, that shows absolutely who he is. I wonder how you respond to that this morning. Where would you be in the accounts that we've heard today? Would you be like Jacob, truly overwhelmed by God's actions and promises, and building a place to mark such a blessing? This certainly seems to be a very reasonable reaction. How do we respond when we know that we have been blessed by God? Do we mark it? Do we tell others about it, wanting them to understand just how awesome God is? That's what Jacob did. Now, it's true to say that what God promised him was amazing. And it is really any less a miracle than when God blesses us, when we know that he has helped us. He's heard our prayers. Perhaps he's gone before us, as we know he always promises to do. When was the last time you know that God blessed you? Or perhaps, not so much like Jacob, you might be a bit more like Nathanael. Just one event of Jesus intervening in your life, and you're utterly convinced now about who he is, having been rather unconvinced previously. Would you say that Jesus is awesome at this point? Would you be able to share that with others, as the disciples did after Jesus' death, resurrection, and ascension? Just your one testimony of what Jesus has done for you in your life could well make the difference to another, convince them, point them to him, so that they too can say that Jesus is awesome. It doesn't take much, just our story, to say what it means to us, and what can God do with it. Amen.
If you're so able, I invite those of you here in church with us to stand for the affirmation of faith. We say together in faith, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. We believe in God the Father, who created all things. For by his will they were created and have their being. We believe in God the Son, who was slain. For with his blood he purchased for God from every tribe and language, from every people and nation. We believe in God the Holy Spirit. The Spirit and the bride say, Come. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. Amen. Do please sit for our prayers. During our prayers this morning, the response to the words, Lord, hear us, is Lord, graciously hear us. There's a typo in the order of service. The space is in the wrong place. So the words beginning with Miachel come at the very end of the prayers, and I'll lead you into those. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Father in heaven, by his blood, your Christ has ransomed us to you and has made us a kingdom and priests to you, our God. As the angels minister to you in heaven, strengthen your church to serve you here on earth. Guide us in this parish as we seek to discern the right way ahead in these times. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Father in heaven, when the angels greeted the birth of your Son, they sang for joy, glory to God and peace on earth. Bless with Christ's peace the nations of the world, particularly those places where there is tension and conflict, Afghanistan, Assyria, the Yemen, the Holy Land. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Father in heaven, your Son promised to your children the care of the guardian angels who look upon your face. Protect by your mercy our neighbors, families, and friends. Be close to all those who at this time are returning to or starting university as students. Be with the staff as they try to carry out their work in these different conditions. And guide Sarah and all members of chaplaincy team. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Father in heaven, you give your angels charge over those who trust in you to guard them in all their ways. Be with those in any kind of trouble or need. And among them, Kelly, Kevin, Lucy, Tom, Andrew and Christine, Heather, Luke, Rahelio, John, Vicky, Yvonne, Dennis, Margaret, and any others known to us. Rescue them and show them your salvation. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Father in heaven, your angel declares, "Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord." Blessed indeed, says the Spirit, for they may rest from their labors, they take with them the record of their deeds. Enfold in your love Peter Hawtrey, Kathleen Peller, Joan Tranner, and all who come to your judgment seat in heaven. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Father in heaven, the angels sing by day and night around your throne, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. With Miachel, Prince of the Angels, who contends by our side. With Gabriel, your herald, who brings glad tidings. With Raphael, the protector, who ministers your healing. With the whole company of heaven, we worship you. We give you glory. We sing your praise and exalt you forever. Amen.
Please stand if you are able. Hear again the song of the angels. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace in whatever way seems most suitable.
And so let us sing together hymn 276, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, 276.
Holy, holy, holy.
God of glory, as you appointed angels to minister in your presence, so may all our worship bring you worthy praise. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Right and good, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. You reveal your wise purpose for the salvation of the human race by assigning to the angels and archangels the ministry of your steadfast love and protection. While they contemplate your glory, standing before you and singing your praise, they keep a faithful vigil for us, guarding us along the way that leads to life, and guiding us towards the kingdom of your light. In joyful gladness, we unite our voices with theirs and sing the ageless hymn of your praise. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord, and as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of our dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again, he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did, and in him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross, bringing before you the bread of life and the cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory.
Great is the mystery of faith.
Lord of life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with Miachel and the archangel and all the angels and saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. Amen.
As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of
every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. God's holy gifts for God's holy people.
Jesus Christ is holy.
Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God the Father.
Thank you.
draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith and with thanksgiving.
Let us pray. Lord of heaven, in this Eucharist you have brought us near to an innumerable company of angels and the spirits of the saints made perfect. As in this food of our earthly pilgrimage we have shared their fellowship, so may we come to share their joy in heaven, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Come to our time for notices that you do have. The notices on the weekly news sheet, those of you online, I hope that you have access to that as well through our website. There's just a few things I'd love to draw your attention to, if I may. Next Sunday is our Harvest Sunday. And if you see the notice there, it says we'll be having our harvest services. Any donations we'll be collecting for the Basics Bank in Southampton and in Eastleigh. And there's a list of all the things that the Basics Bank are really looking for at the moment. Not necessarily exactly the same. Some people seem to get more of one than the other. So if you're not able to come to church, then please put your donations in the box just outside the rectory front door or outside the parish office just here on the site here. Thank you. Now, Norman has a starring role again tomorrow at All Saints when he shares with us the parish's view that he's discovered of what the church buildings are for through his research during COVID. So all are welcome at All Saints Church tomorrow at 7:30. And calling again all knitters for an angel bomb. Here we have the Feast of All Angels. We would love to bless the whole parish, North Stoneham Park, all the way down to Old Bassett with angels. So we're looking for, ideally, at least 500. So I don't know whether any of you are knitters, but perhaps that'd be something that you could get knitting for. That'd be great. Thank you. So we are now going to stand and sing our final hymn, Ye Holy Angels Bright, number 826. Ye Holy Angels Bright, 826.
and the blessing. God keep you in the fellowship of his saints. Christ protect you by the ministry of the angels, and the Spirit make you holy in God's service. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Blessing and honor and thanksgiving and praise, more than we can utter, more than we can conceive, be to you, most holy and glorious Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, from all angels and all people and all creatures, forever and ever.